What is your objection to my faith?
Objections? I never said nothing to you. I never said nothing to you.
You were commenting on my Christian faith. What is your objection?
I was asking what topic you are speaking.
Yeah.
So I want you to know, but everyone's talking to each other. That's why I walked away. Okay. I don't deal with people like that.
Okay. Are you Muslim?
Alhamdulillah.
Are you Sunni, Shia, Quran only?
No, Muslim.
Should I treat that as Sunni Muslim?
He follows the Rasul Sunni.
Sir, you just didn't want to talk to me right now. I want to have proper conversation with him. Can I have proper conversation with him? Is that okay, sir? Smoking kills.
Pardon?
Smoking kills.
I know.
First, before it kills, it makes you suffer. It makes you to suffer and then kills.
That's your choice. I know, my wife tells me every day.
So, sorry, I'm just going to move my stuff here, okay? Or if you come this way, I don't mind smoking, sir. If you come this way.
Jesus came to save you.
This is the Bible of the time of Jesus. There's hundreds of different Bibles. Which one? Tell me, which one?
Sir, are you coming?
Yes.
It is very much serious regarding smoking, you know that.
Pardon?
It is very much serious regarding the smoking. It makes you suffer and die.
I know.
So, you are Muslim. Can you give me your reasons why you are Muslim?
I don't want to go into that. I'm not here to debate about that. So, you ask me who I am, I'm a Muslim?
Yeah.
Yeah,
you don't want to, you don't have any reasons, or you don't want to give me your reasons?
I believe in my research.
Yeah.
I'm not Muslim because I was born Muslim.
What's your name?
Adil. I'm not Muslim because I was born a Muslim. I'm Muslim because as I grew up, I studied all religions, and I'm going to know why I'm a Muslim. So I studied all the religions, and I come back to Islam. I never went away from Islam, but I'm just explaining to you. So I know your Bible, I know Hinduism, I know Sikhism, I know all the religions.
Okay. I'll ask you a question about Islam.
Okay.
Because
I'm not going to answer if I've studied it, if I know about it. I'm not going to answer if I don't know.
That's fine. If you don't know, just tell me you don't know. So, I'm very much disturbed by the teachings of Islam. Not only disturbed, but I see it as a very dangerous to humanity.
But dangerous is a big word.
Yeah.
I'm gonna
back up.
Okay.
And then if I am wrong, please do correct me. So, for you to be Muslim, you must have a full submission to Muhammad. Yet when I look at the teachings of Muhammad...
No. Submission to God.
Surah 4 verse 65.
Surah what? Can I guys join you?
No, sir.
You don't like me?
Can you please allow me to have the conversation?
Because
if you want to have a conversation,
I'm a native Arabic speaker, so I can translate the verse for you.
Once I finish the conversation, I'm happy to talk to you.
Can I listen to
because
me?
I didn't like your heckling.
Surah 4
verse 65.
Surah 4 verse 65. So, Allah and Muhammad is kind of essence of Islam, okay?
Let's stay on the verse. 65.
65.
Surah Nisa.
Yeah.
I can read it a little bit. But know by your Lord, they will not truly believe until they make you, O Muhammad. Yeah? In brackets. Judge concerning that over which they dispute among themselves, and then find within themselves no discomfort from what you have judged, and submit and full willing. This is not talking about Muhammad. What's this talking about Muhammad? Explain to me what you think. What do you understand?
Is that talking about Muhammad?
No.
By your Lord.
So
Muhammad is the... Do you know the... Okay. Allah Azza wa Jal gave Muhammad... This is Allah talking. This is not Muhammad. Quran Sunnah is when Muhammad, peace be upon him, that's Sunnah. This is Allah's will.
So where does Muhammad... Allah in his eternal word, which is the Quran, tells, okay, what you have judged and submitted in full submission. So they've got nothing to do, but no, by your Lord, they will not believe, okay, they will not believe until they make you, okay. They make you.
Can I read the verse before and after as well?
I can read before, yeah. And then we read the...
Then the context, we need to
yeah,
see the context.
And then we read the tafsir, okay? And then I'll summarize the tafsir to you as well. And we did not send any messenger except to be obeyed by the permission of Allah. And if...
Yeah, but what do you understand?
Let me first read it, okay? And if, when they wronged themselves, they had come to you and asked forgiveness of Allah, and the messenger had asked forgiveness for them, they would have found Allah accepting of repentance and merciful. But no, by your Lord, they will not believe until they make you, not they make Allah, they make you judge concerning that over which they dispute among themselves, and then find within themselves no discomfort from what you have judged and submit in submission. Okay? So
to Allah. If you understand the basis of Quran, Muhammad, this is not Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam speaking. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Allah is speaking. Allah is giving message to Gabriel.
Revelation.
Gabriel is passing to Muhammad. Muhammad is telling people. Muhammad is telling
so
people. Allah is saying. Allah is saying.
Because I don't think you understand this verse.
Explain it to me.
She doesn't understand it.
65.
This is what nothing to do with submission. Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam comes with the Sunnah.
Do you know what the Sunnah is first?
This comes with the Sunnah. Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is the teaching and sayings and the lifestyle of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the Sunnah. Quran is strictly Allah's words. Yeah?
So Quran is Allah's word?
Yes.
Okay. I'll debunk that in a second. Okay. If Quran is word of Allah...
Because it starts with Iqra,
yeah? Let,
do you know
let
what Iqra
finish.
Means?
Read.
Let me finish.
Just remember Iqra.
So, Surah Fatiha. Who is speaking in Surah Fatiha?
Allah.
Allah is speaking. Okay? Turn with
I know
me.
About heart, so...
So, is it Allah who is asked to be guided to straight path?
But that, it doesn't say that. It doesn't say
if
that.
If Allah is speaking...
It's not saying that.
If the Allah is speaking... In the name of Allah, the merciful and gracious, okay? All praises to Allah, Lord of universe. Yes. Allah says all praise to Allah.
So Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is telling everyone,
let
all praises to Allah.
No. Allah is speaking. That's yes. What your argument is, okay? The
so
entire
mankind,
merciful
mankind,
and specially merciful.
Right,
so very often, day of the recompense. It is you, okay? Allah is speaking. It is you. We worship, and you, we ask for help. Allah is speaking.
Yes.
Allah is saying, it is you. Yes. No, it's not. It is me you ask for help. It is you.
If it's me, Muhammad
it is you.
Sorry, I need to tell you. I need to answer what you just said. If he says me, then people are going to... If Muhammad is preaching, it's going to be me. That means it's Muhammad speaking. If he says me, you just said me.
I didn't say it.
You did.
It is you.
Okay, you, exactly.
It is you. We worship. It is not Allah. It is not Allah.
Who's
it is
you?
Someone.
You,
yeah, that's my question to you.
Who
say,
is
you say, you said Allah is speaking.
No.
You said, Adil, you said Allah is speaking. It is you we worship. Okay? Allah is speaking. Allah says, it is something we worship. And we ask for help. Guide us to straight path. Allah is saying, guide us to straight path, to the path of those whom you have bestowed favor, not of those who earned your anger, or those who gone
okay.
Straight.
Do you know who God's talking about there? Do you know who ashkar and anger means?
No.
Do you know who he's talking
Adil,
about?
Adil, I know the Muslim interpretation for the context, okay? So, Muslim interpretation is this is towards Jewish and Christians.
Jewish and Christians.
Okay? So that's Muslim
Jewish,
interpretation.
That's
but you said everything in the Quran is the word of Allah. So if everything is in the Quran, is the word of Allah, Allah is asking, Allah is saying, there is someone Allah says, it is you we worship. It is you we ask for help. Guide us, that someone, to the straight path. Okay? So that's my first debunk to you. My second...
That's not debunk.
That is... Let me finish. Let me finish.
Okay.
The second point is, can you be Muslim, okay? Can you be Muslim without Allah and Muhammad?
No.
No. So, for you to be Muslim, you need to know what Muhammad said, what Muhammad did, what Muhammad didn't say. So you need his customs for you to live life of Muslims.
We need to know about all the prophets. We need to know about all the angels. We need to know about everything. It's not limited just to Muhammad. We need to know everything. Abraham faith, there were books of Abraham, but they weren't found. The scrolls of Abraham weren't found. Yeah?
Sorry, what are those books of Abraham?
There were scriptures. There were scrolls.
What are them?
I said to you, they weren't found. No one has.
Where does it say?
That's another topic. I'll find out for you. But let me finish. Let me answer your answer. Yeah? So, now we have to believe in everything. You limit it to Muhammad and just Allah. You have to believe in all the prophets, all the angels. You have to believe in heaven and hell. You have to believe in all the heavens, hells. You have to believe in the devil. You have to believe in the return of Isa bin Maryam. You have to believe in everything.
Okay.
So it's not just what you just said.
So in that everything, okay, in that everything, for example, let's put that to test. How often do you read the biography of Jesus to find out what he said, what he did?
Okay. Well, as a Muslim, what I see or what I know about Jesus, is that what you're
asking? No. So you said actually you have to believe all the prophets.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
In that whole prophet list, you've got someone called Jesus, according to you.
About his life and how
okay?
His life.
Okay. So that Jesus, in his biography, for example, he says, pray to me. Do you pray to Jesus?
Where does he say in the Quran, pray to you?
No,
you said you read you have to believe in Jesus. So where do you go to believe in Jesus?
I'm going to believe in Isa bin Maryam in the Quran. Not
in the Quran, okay.
The
so
Quran,
you don't believe you don't believe the Jesus of the Bible.
No, of course not.
So, but you believe in the previous books.
Yes.
So, but in that previous books, let me finish.
Yeah,
I'm just trying to put together. In that previous books, okay, you've got the biography of Jesus, and you don't take his sayings, but you take the sayings of Jesus from the Quran.
Okay.
That's already problematic for me. That already shows, actually, you don't believe in Jesus, but you believe someone called Isa.
No. Well, I'll tell you what you're trying to say. I'm going to explain a bit of what you're trying to say. She's trying to say... The Jesus of the
Bible.
Can
you look at me when you
speak
to me?
The Jesus of Bible. I'm not following the Jesus of Bible. That's what you're trying to say.
Okay, so you don't follow.
That's what you're saying.
Is that correct?
Am I Christian?
No, I'm just trying to understand.
You
said you follow all the prophets. You have to believe in all the prophets.
Yes, but you asked me a question which you know the answer already.
So, you believe all the prophets, but you don't believe Prophet Jesus.
When did I say that? You're saying that. You're putting words in
your mouth. You believe Prophet Isa, you don't believe Prophet Jesus.
Prophet Isa bin Maryam. In the Quran. Yes. I believe.
Okay. Not the one in the Bible.
What?
Not the one in the Bible.
But you're referring to the Bible, he's the God.
In the Injil that was given to Isa bin Maryam is not the Injil you have. That's my answer.
Okay, can you give me any reference for that?
Sorry?
Can you give me any reference for that?
The reference?
Yep.
Trinity?
No, give me the Injil.
No, I'm telling you.
No, I'm not talking about the doctrine. Give me the... No. I want you to give me the reference that Injil is given to Jesus, which we don't have it. That's my first thing, but I want to focus on...
If you let me elaborate, I'll explain it.
No. Because it seems that topic is just circulating around.
No, but you can't
I'm
limit...
I'm trying to focus
you can't
on...
limit on your questions and answers the way you want it. So I'm going to tell you how it is. Yeah? So in the Injil... Okay. Trinity is not in the Bible, but the Trinity is in the Quran.
So Trinity is not in the Bible.
Do you know this?
Trinity is not in the Bible.
The word Trinity.
The word Trinity is not in the Bible,
it's
but it's
teachings.
In the Quran.
It's what you've been taught. You've been taught this, yeah?
Adil, can you look at me when you talk to me? It's helpful for the communication skills.
Okay. Now, do you know the Trinity is mentioned in the Quran? Do you know that?
Where is it mentioned?
You don't know that, yeah?
Where is it mentioned?
So, have you read the Quran first?
I read the Quran.
All of the Quran.
Where is it mentioned?
So how do you not know that? Then that means you haven't read it.
No, show me. But my question was the Jesus, the angel which Jesus received.
I know what your question is. I know exactly what you're
trying to say. No, just first bring me the Trinity of the Quran.
Trinity
of the
Quran, yeah?
Are you going to talk to me or I'm canceling? You're not going to talk to me?
So you went to Google?
Sorry, don't look at me. Why are you watching my stuff for?
So you just went to Google?
No, I'm explaining to you, innit? Because there's not one verse, there's loads.
So you went to Google, and then which website's article is that?
Let me finish and I'll give you everything. Okay. Surah An-Nisa 417 and Surah Al-Maidah 574, 573, check it.
Surah 4?
Al-Maidah 573.
No, first give me the Surah 4 one.
It talks about the Father, Son and Holy Spirit.
No, first give me the Surah 4 one. What is the reference Surah 4?
It's 4, 171.
Just read that.
Surah 4, 171.
The Father, okay. Son and Holy Ghost. And the where they went wrong.
So can you help me with this? So Surah 4, verse 171. All people of the scripture.
Surah Maidah.
The Surah 4, that's the reference he gave me.
What is Surah Maidah? It's
5, 5, 1, 7.
So let's start with the first one, Surah 4, verse 171.
No, I'm telling you to stay on this one.
Okay, so the article was misguiding you regarding Surah 4, verse 171.
Why would you take my words when
No, because you don't want to look at the verse. You gave me two references, so let's look at the first one first, and then we'll look at the second one. Okay, so I want you to explain the Trinity from Surah 4, verse 171. So let me tell you what I believe as a Christian, so that we are all in the same page for the Trinity. Or do you know about it?
I know.
Okay. It is practically difficult, okay? Especially when you wear mask. If you are not looking at me, it's difficult to understand.
I'm listening to you.
Okay. No, for my sake, when you speak, it is difficult to understand, okay? So, all people of the scripture, do not commit excess in your religion or say about Allah except the truth. The Messiah, Jesus, son of Mary, was but a messenger of Allah, his word, which cast down to Mary, and a soul or spirit
directed to Mary.
Arabic says cast down to. Arabic says to cast down.
No. Okay, anyway, carry on.
And a spirit
word,
from him.
Custom,
it's Arabic. It's in the Arabic.
Okay. I'm just reading what's in front of you.
Can you just point out to the Muslims who are just praying over there? Cameraman, can you just turn
they're
to the
mic?
Come
no
to the camera over there? Yeah, that's fine. So,
why are you disturbing
the Messiah, them? Jesus, son of Mary, was but a messenger of Allah.
Nice. I don't think I really want to talk to you anymore now. Because someone's praying peacefully, they're disturbing no one, and what are you doing to them?
If they are not disturbing anything, there is no problem, then why are you having a problem?
Because you said you praise the
Yeah, I just wanted to address that on the camera, because I want to use that. That's fine. That's fine. So believe in Allah and the messengers, and do not say three deities. It is better for you. Indeed. Sorry. Since when Trinity and three is the same thing?
Explaining to you. You believe
it is better for you. Indeed. But Allah is but one God. Exalted He above having a son. To Him belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is on earth. And sufficient is Allah as the spore of affair. So you said to me the word Trinity is mentioned in the Quran. So this in the first reference it is not there.
Three means Trinity. Let's go to the second one.
So, three is different than Trinity.
Listen, if you want to have a decent, genuine discussion, so I will carry on.
Three is different from the Trinity.
I don't have time.
There is a word in English for Trinity as well as for tree, and same in Arabic, there is a word for tree and word for Trinity. Okay, so now Surah 4 verse 170 is not one of them. What was your second reference? Surah Maida?
No. You, it's there. You're saying it's not.
Explain it to me.
And you missed the word directly.
Explain it to me.
You made your own word custom. Just remember that, yeah? Anyway, let's move on.
Explain it to me. If it's that, explain it.
No, let's move on. You can't.
No, explain it to me, sir.
You can't understand.
Yeah, why do? How do you know I can't?
Because it's black and white. Okay, let's move on.
I read it again for the views. Okay, it's black and white.
Sir, I don't want to be on camera. I'm not here for camera.
Okay, then walk away, please.
Yeah.
All people of the scripture, do not commit excess in your religion or say about Allah except the truth. The Messiah, Jesus, son of Mary, was but a messenger of Allah, his word, which was cast down to Mary, and the spirit, from him. So believe in Allah and his messenger, and do not say three deities. It is better for you. Indeed, Allah is but one God. Exalt is he above having a son. To him belongs whatever is in the heaven and whatever is on earth, and sufficient is Allah as disposer of affairs. So you made a claim. You made a claim that the word Trinity is in the Quran, and I cannot see the word Trinity in English translation.
So I am confident that word
is not in Arabic.
What religion has three? Only Christians.
So three what? Three what?
You believe in Trinity.
Three what?
Trinity. Father, Son, Holy Ghost.
No, three is what?
Father, Son, Holy Ghost.
Three is what? Are three gods.
So the Quran's telling
you. Do I believe in three gods?
What do you believe in?
I don't believe in three gods. I believe in one God, yes.
Essence of three, yeah?
One essence, three persons.
So that's the same thing?
No,
three persons.
Three persons is
the same thing.
No, person.
That's the same thing.
Verse as your prophet. Your prophet is freaking bad.
No.
Example is the man who walked away.
No, listen, look.
Example is the way he walked away.
I'm talking to you in respect. So,
I don't believe in three gods. Okay? So right now, this verse is talking about someone who believes in three gods. It has nothing to do with me. So now, can you point me where the word Trinity has been mentioned in the Quran? What was your second reference?
I'll show you.
Surah of Maida what?
Surah 573.
573.
If you don't read it properly, I'll read it for you.
Please read it. It's your book.
You done that?
No, read it.
Trust
in me. They have certainly disbelieved who say Allah is the third of three.
Yeah?
How do you know this is for Christians?
Reading,
I never say Allah is the third of three. You are Christian. Do you say Allah is the third of three? I never
Allah.
Say that.
So what are you talking
about? Yeah, I never say that. So
can you read the verse?
Yeah.
I'm gonna go there.
They have certainly disbelieved who say Allah is the third of three. That's not me. I never say Allah is the third of three.
You just said three.
And there
persons.
Is three person is very different than saying Allah as one being one of third. I don't say that. Your Allah didn't know the basics.
Can you tell me?
And there is no God except one God. And if they do not desist from what they are saying, there will surely afflict the disbelievers among them a painful punishment. So you stated Trinity has been mentioned in the Quran.
Are you here next week?
Why are you going now? You haven't even finished
your
statement. I have done my homework. You are the one who needs to do homework. So Muslims stated that Trinity is in the Quran. Surah 4 verse 171 has nothing to do with the Trinity, I believe. Surah 5 verse 73 has nothing to do with what I believe. And the word Trinity is not there. Sad day for Allah, doesn't even know what Christians believe. Therefore, I've got not much expectations from Muslims. Who knows not much better than Allah? Ma'am, why do you think Muhammad was a good person? Okay, so you don't believe Muhammad was a good person then?
No.
Muslims don't even want to talk about their prophet, say Muhammad was good
Jesus
prophet. You
truth.
Said you went, you
Jesus
were gonna go. Let me tell you the truth. The truth is, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Lord Jesus Christ, eternal Son of God, stepped into this broken world and died on the cross for the sin of humanity. And that God, with his death and his resurrection, offers humanity eternal life. That is the God I believe, and that is the God I want to honor.
You're not sincere. If you're sincere...
Of course, I'm not sincere, and therefore you are running away. I can see that.
Because I gave you already 10 minutes of my life.
I can see that.
So?
I can see that.
I gave you 10 minutes of my life.
So I can see that.
When you're ready for next week,
you regret it.
Do I regret it? Yeah, I regret it now because I see your true nature.
Yeah.
You've been refuted with the same questions.
Yeah.
What you do is another Muslim with the same
questions. I have been refuted with the same questions.
What you do
but
is,
still none of the Muslims have any question to answer. Any answer to the basic questions I am asking. Basic questions I have been asking. Muslims are running away. They don't even want to talk about it. All they do is, we refute you and run away. What I have been refuted? What is it I have been refuted, sir? What is it being I have been refuted? What are those same questions?
You're not sincere.
Tell me what are those questions I've been asking.
What's your channel? What's your YouTube? Put yourself on YouTube.
Do you see the aperture?
Put yourself
that
on YouTube.
That is the sign of lying. Look at the lying faces.
Okay, watch YouTube.
Like face of
YouTube
Muhammad, not much different.
Internet, you can't do nothing.
Sir, what are the questions? What are the questions I've been defeated? Are you God? Oh, well, your Allah doesn't know what I believe. I have got not much expectations from Muslims anyway. But the bottom line is, actually, they really, really, really don't even know. It is sad reality, actually. Muslims believe Allah is all-knowing and all-wise. But Allah doesn't even know. What, as I, a Christian, I believe. Allah doesn't even know what his previous books are teaching. Comes up and then puts those freaking verses in the Quran full of lies and full of lies and full of lies. That's what we expect from one who is identified as the best of deceivers and his name is Allah.
Do you want to talk to me?
And she goes, no,